Hi, Miles.
Hi.
Don't be shy. I don't know why he's so shy. This is my nephew, guys. This is my nephew, my handsome nephew, Miles. I brought him here today because I want to talk to young girls about dating with alopecia. But before we get into that, let's ask Miles what kind of girls he likes.
I don't know what kind of girls that I like. It doesn't really matter to me. As long as I see that you have a nice personality and, like, you're not ugly. Yeah, that's really it.
So you just have to have a nice personality and not be ugly.
Yeah.
So what's ugly?
I mean, I can't really describe it. I mean, you could look good, but if you do certain stuff, you could be ugly to me.
Like what kind of stuff?
Like smoking cigarettes and stuff like that. That's
nasty.
Yeah, that's disgusting.
So, I know you have an aunt, obviously, that's me, who has alopecia. So you know what alopecia is, right?
When you go bald, right?
Yeah, it's basically when you go bald, right?
Yeah.
So, would you date a girl who has alopecia?
Yeah. I mean, there's no reason for me not to.
Why?
I mean, I don't know how to explain it. I mean, if I don't see anything wrong with you, then of course I would.
So there's what you're saying is there's really nothing wrong with alopecia.
No.
Okay. So do you think that you would feel that way if you didn't have an aunt who had alopecia?
Yeah.
You'd still feel the same way.
Sometimes I forget, to be honest, that you have it.
Yeah, which is weird because you see me bald all the time.
Yeah, I don't know why.
You ready? You want to add anything else about dating? Okay. What kind of girl would you? Well, you already said you wouldn't date a girl who smokes.
Yeah.
You already said you don't even know what ugly is. Ugly to you is more like
I mean, some girls can be physically ugly to me.
Like, what would be ugly?
I don't know how to explain it. It's just...
But it's not baldness.
No.
That's not it.
I don't even mind if you're, like... As long as you're not, like, obese, I could take a little dick, but it's not... Can't be too much.
Okay, so I know what you're thinking. You're thinking, oh, come on, that's your nephew. Of course he's going to say that, and... You are probably right, but I'm going to say you're wrong anyway, because I have always had boyfriends. Always. I lost my hair. Let's start from the beginning. My name is Jacqueline Bennett. I'm from New York. I've had alopecia since I was a 12-year-old girl. I'm now 42 years old, and I have always had boyfriends. I don't think alopecia really matters that much in the big scheme of dating. You don't need to have alopecia for some guy to not want you.
You don't have to be bald-headed to have a hard time getting a boyfriend. There's all kinds of reasons why girls don't have boyfriends and why guys don't have girlfriends. There's all kinds of reasons, and it's not all about hair. In fact, every alopecia princess that I know who's had alopecia for at least 3 years is in a long-term relationship or is married. And that's just the truth. I think there's a good reason for that too. I think it's because we have one up on the average girl. I'm close to the airport, so yeah, there's lots of airplanes going by, but I think we have one up on the average girl. I think the average hot chick thinks that they deserve to be liked and desired by every guy, and I think they have a hard time accepting when they don't, when a guy doesn't like them. I think they don't get it. Like, it's just like, why doesn't this guy get it? Why? Us alopecia princesses, we have accepted, for the most part, we have accepted the fact that everybody's not going to like us, and that's okay. There's beautiful women who have nothing physically wrong with them who cannot keep a boyfriend, cannot get it. They just can't do it. And it's not because of their hair. So my nephew is no different than every other 15-year-old that I've ever met in my whole life. They're all the same. They care a little bit, but they care mostly about how you make them feel. That's what boys like. Guys love a girl who can make them feel good. They just don't want to be embarrassed, that's all. clearly, if you're going through that time in your life where all the kids are teasing you and pulling your wig off in school, then that's not a time where a guy's going to want to be with you, because you're dealing with embarrassment, and he may not want to deal with that embarrassment. But I got to be honest with you. When I was 13 years old and I was getting teased like a horrible, getting bullied like crazy, it was horrible. There was one guy, and he loved me, and he was in my class. It's always been somebody who didn't give a shit. So when is a good time to tell a guy that you don't have hair? I would say a good time would be probably around the third date. Let me let this airplane go by. By the third date, you have spent some time together. He's had enough time to look at your hair and probably think, is that her hair? So he's probably wondering about it anyway. So that's a good time for you to say, oh yeah, by the way, I hope you're okay with the fact that I wear this wig. That's how you do it. Like, don't make it any more complicated than that. Anything else, when you approach the subject, you want to do it without freaking the guy out. And you do that just by keeping it real, real simple. Now, oh, I have alopecia universalis, and I, made all my hair fall out. It's a autoimmune disease. You start saying all that, you're going to freak him out. So, hey, Bob, are you okay with the fact that I wear this wig? So Bob is probably going to say one of two things. That's a wig? Because he clearly didn't know. Or, get out of here, that's not a wig. Because he did know, and now he's pretending that he didn't know. Or, yeah, I meant to ask you about that. Which means he's ready to do some talking. In either sense, I think he's ready to do some talking. Because it's time to do some talking. You want to tell them before somebody else says it, before their cousins or aunts or friend or somebody says, that's not her hair. You can't tell she doesn't have eyebrows. Before somebody else says it, you say it. Somebody may have already said it. Somebody may have beat you to it. But guess what? Bob is still right here. Which means he's okay with it. He's all right. So then you tell Bob, I have an allergy that makes my hair fall out, which is not a lie, because an autoimmune disease is akin to an allergy. I have an allergy and it makes my hair fall out, so I have to wear the wigs or I'll just be bald, which I could also do, but I choose to wear wigs. Take from there, Bob might sit there and entertain your conversation and then never answer your calls again. Or Bob might call you tomorrow. Bob might be perfectly fine with it. So the next question is, when do you show Bob your head? When is it okay for you to remove that wig and say, look at me, Bob, I'm bald? Well, this is something I didn't do when I was a kid. A, because we didn't have cell phones. And B, because I didn't think of it. But I have taken some glamour shots, bald-headed, and I can keep the pictures in my phone. I look great in those bald pictures, and if Bob wants to see what I look like before I actually yank my wig off, then I can just show him a picture. That works great. That works great. I've showed all my friends at work what I look like bald by showing them pictures, girls and guys, just by showing them pictures on my phone. And it eases the tension, because a lot of times guys don't know, or people don't know what to expect under that wig. They don't know what they're going to see. You might pull your wig off and literally have bright red hair or blonde hair or patchy bald spots or scarring alopecia. They don't know what to expect. So you just show them. And you want to be as appealing as possible when you're bald. Even though baldness may not be appealing to you, you can still be beautiful. I'm sure you see many instances of women who are gorgeous while being bold at the same time. You could be one of them. You just need to learn how to, you know, put your eyebrows in a way that accentuates your bald head. You just need to learn how to dress in a way that accentuates your new silhouette. You may just need to put on some blush or some eyeshadow, which I'm pretty impressed with my new eyeshadow technique. Anyway, yeah, make yourself beautiful bald and say, this is what I look like, honey, in a picture. Or you could just pull it off like I did when I showed my husband. I know he was sitting there like, oh wow, you really are bald. I have a video of that, by the way. You should check it out.
Okay, so the next question would be, have I ever been rejected specifically because I'm bald? And the answer would be no. No, never in my life specifically because I'm bald. In hindsight, I can say that. I probably didn't know that at the time. But it's probably more because I was being weird than because I was being bald. I remember one time I met this guy at a party or something like that. And we danced the whole night long. I was probably like 19 years old and I met him at this party. We danced the whole night long and we were vibing. I mean, this music had us going and we were feeling the music and we were having a great time. And I was like, this guy is hot. Okay, this was back in my thought days, you know. I was never a thought. Because I've always been in long relationships. So if I was ever out of a relationship for, you know, a couple months, then I would meet some guy. Right? So I met this guy. And so we had a good time. And then we exchanged numbers at the end of the night. And then we planned to meet the next day. So he asked me, and girls, don't follow what I did. This is bad. This was me being a bad girl, right? So he asked me, oh, let's meet at my house. I have my own apartment. And at 20 years old, most guys don't have apartments, but he had his own apartment. So I get to his house, and we're making out, right? We're just kissing. And I stopped, and I said, and I don't know why I did this. I can't imagine why anybody would approach the situation like this. But I said, you know, I don't have any hair. And he said, what? Because, you know, we just finished kissing. So he says, what? And then I said, I don't have any hair because I have alopecia. And I pulled my wig off. And he's just sitting there looking at me like, and then he said, put your wig back on. And I said, okay. And I don't remember anything after that, but I'm sure that date ended right there. So, you guys tell me. You be the judge. Was I rejected because I was bald or because I was weird? I would have to say the latter. Guys, be nice. Listen. Listen to guys. When you're out, when you're meeting guys, when you're getting to know a guy, listen to him. He has lots to say, and a lot of times he'll tell you exactly who he is and what his intentions are while he's talking. So try to do more listening and less talking, because it can help you to avoid a lot of painful situations. So what is my biggest tip, my most important tip I think I can give a girl who is out, you know, trying to find a boyfriend is, I wish you didn't have to try to find a boyfriend, first of all. It's not that important to have a boyfriend, but when you're looking for a boyfriend, it's hard to tell someone, hey, you don't need a boyfriend. Not when they're ready, not when you want a boyfriend. So, okay, so you want to find a boyfriend. Here's what you don't do. Please always leave the ball in the guy's court. Always do that. Don't force yourself on a guy by calling him all the time or checking up on him all the time, because, you know, we have this way of doing that, like saying, oh, I'm not calling because I want to go out, I'm just checking up on him to make sure he's good because I haven't heard from him in a while. Yeah, don't do that. If he wanted you to know how he was doing, he would call you, trust me on that. You meet a guy, say, hey, how's it going, you know, You might want to say, listen, you're into, I don't know, rock climbing, right? You're into spin class, or you like movies, right? Let's go check out this new Wonder Woman movie that just came out. You like the Marvel movies, right? Let's go check out Wonder Woman. And leave it at that. Say, here's my number. Call me if you want to go check it out, because I want to see it too. So, you know, just call me if you want to go. Now, he will do either one of two things. He will, one, call you and say, come on, let's go. Or he will, two, not call you. Guess what he just told you? If you were listening, he just told you, I'm not interested. And that's fine, because everybody doesn't have to be interested in you. And it doesn't have to be about your hair. He might not even know about your hair yet. He just doesn't want to go to movies with you because, I don't know, maybe your breasts are too flat, or maybe he doesn't like your skin color or your teeth. I don't know. Guys, maybe he didn't feel a vibe. It could be nothing at all. It could be just he's still hung up on his ex. It could be anything. It could be that he doesn't even like girls that much. He hasn't even figured out why he doesn't like girls that much. It could be because he's gay, doesn't even know it yet, or gay and does know it. Like, there's so many reasons why a guy might not like you. So please don't just automatically go back, oh, it's because I'm getting bald, and now you're going to go in your room and sulk about being bald. Dude, it may have had nothing to do with you being bald. Trust me. So don't call him, you know. Now, this is where it gets tricky. I told you don't call him. But you like him so much, and you saw him today at school, and he was at work, and he looked so nice. And you really, really want to know how come he didn't call you. Hey, you don't really need to know how come he didn't call you. He doesn't owe you an explanation for not calling you. There's no rule that says he has to call you. But if you really want to know, you could wait a week. Wait 1 week. And if you can't do that, then go tape your mouth closed, because you need to practice some self-control. Wait a week and then say, look, I was about to go to the movies this weekend and I haven't heard from you. Do you still want to go? You could say that. He could do even one or two things. He could say, oh, I already saw it last week, actually. Or, no, I'm busy this weekend. Or, and what he's basically saying is, I'm not interested, which is fine. He doesn't have to be interested in you. Or he'll say, oh, yeah, hold on. Let me go clock out from work and then we'll go see this movie. And then you could take it from there. But don't call him after that. You don't want to guilt someone into dating you. You don't want to guilt someone into sleeping with you, because a guy will do that. Guys think like that. They think like, okay, I'll just go out with her because she just really looks like she needs to go out on a date and I want to do her this favor. Guys actually think like that. There's some narcissistic mofos, let me tell you. Some narcissistic people men can be. They're doing you a favor, they're taking you out. And you know what? If you're begging, then actually it looks like you need a favor. So stop begging. Don't be that. Don't be that girl. Don't be that girl.